This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning to all. Now we are going to discuss the loop or circuit. Previous class I already explained the basic terminology of network theory, network topology. We have seen what is network, what is branch, what is node, what is the graph of corresponding network, what are the trees of the graph, what is the tree branches, properties of tree, and properties of trees, and also we have seen incident matrix formation and formation of incident matrix, and also we done with the properties of incident matrix. Later I explain what is the significance, what is the importance of, what are the advantages of a reduced incident matrix, how reduced incident matrix formed from the incident matrix, complete incident matrix. Now today I'm going to discuss, the loop or circuit and remaining two matrices and corresponding problems. Now, what is loop? If a link is added, to a tree, the resultant graph contains one closed path called a loop. See, if a link is added to a tree, we know already what is a tree. A tree is nothing but a subgraph of a graph, given graph. And also, the number of nodes present in the graph should be equal to the number of nodes present in the tree. And there is no closed loop. Here, what I'm telling is, if any link is added to tree, if any link branch is added to tree, the resulting contains one closed path, that will be a loop or circuit. The next following are the properties of loop. The first property, there are exactly two paths between any pair of nodes in the circuit. That means, consider node 1 and 2, the path from 1 to 2, and similarly 2 to 1. There are two paths between any two nodes, Next property, there exist at least two branches in a loop. So that loop will form. Now, the maximum possible branches in a loop are equal to the number of nodes in the graph. So this property is nothing but, now, number of branch after forming the loop, the number of branches are 4, for example, those 4 will be the, definitely number of nodes will be the 4. Maximum possible branches are not more than the number of nodes present in the original graph. Next, loop which contains only one link or independent are called basic or fundamental loops or tie-set. The number of F loops is equal to the number of links. Already I explained, I told what is link. Link is nothing but a branch of co-tree. Represent with dotted lines. Next, last, orientation of F loop. That means direction of fundamental loop is chosen to be same as that of its link. Now, in this, the loop is, the loop branches are taken, the loop branches directions are taken with respect to the link present in that loop. Next slide. Now, to describe the way in which the branch constitute loops or meshes. Loop or circuit matrix is used to write the matrix in a systematic way. An orientation is specified for each loop using an ordered list of its branches and nodes. The orientation is arbitrary. Now, the complete loop matrix B suffix C of a linear graph having B branches is a matrix with B columns and as many rows as the loops the graph has. This sentence tells us number of loops are 3. We will get number of links are 3. We will get number of loops. So depends upon the links only, we will get loops. If links are 4, we will get 4 loops. So that we will get 4 loop equations. Now, what is the representation? See everyone. Plus 1. If branch B is in loop L and their orientations are same. For example, this is nothing but in a loop, some two or three branches are present. In that, there is a link also present. Now, branch direction in the loop, branch direction and loop direction is same, that will be treated as plus 1, minus 1. If branch B is in loop L and their orientations are opposite, that means if branch direction B and loop direction, that is link direction L, are opposite, that will be treated as minus 1. If branch B is not in loop L, that will be treated as 0. The total number of loops are determined using exhaustive search. Next, see everyone, this is a generalized graph. So this is general. I'm going to write the loop matrix for this. Then after, I will take one more graph and I will solve fundamental circuit matrix or tie set matrix. Now first see this graph, generalized graph. In this graph, see everyone, node 1, node 2, node 3, and node 4. Branches are A, B, C, D, E. How many branches are there? A, B, C. According to my convenience, I am taking 3 loops. Loop 1, loop 2, and loop 3. Loop 1 is nothing but branches. Loop 1 branches are A, B, D. This is a closed circuit. A, B, D. Now, loop 2 branches are B, C, E. Now, B, C, E. Next, loop 3 directions are A, loop 3 branches are A, C, E, D. Now, according to my convenience, I took all 3 loop directions are clockwise directions only. See everyone, clockwise direction. Starting here, like this, clockwise direction. Starting here, like this. Now, first, I am writing the loop equations. So in instant matrix also, we have taken branches in horizontal direction, A, B, C, D, E. Now, in instant matrix, we consider nodes in vertical manner. Whereas here, see everyone, 1, 2, 3 are our loops. Our loops, 1, 2, 3 are our loops. A, B, C, D, E are branches. Now, loop 1. In loop 1, see everyone, first loop and second loop and third loop directions are by default, I consider clockwise direction. Now, I am going to write the values of each branch. Values of each branch. Now, loop 1. A also clockwise direction, D also clockwise direction, but B is in anti-clockwise direction. That's right. B value is minus 1 and remaining A, D are plus 1 and branches C and E are does not belongs to loop 1. That's why I consider C and E 0, 0. Next, in loop 2. Loop 2 direction also clockwise direction. In loop 2, branches are B, C, E. Now, branch B and branch E are clockwise direction, same like loop direction. That's why I took plus 1 for B and plus 1 for E. C is in anti-clockwise direction with respect to the loop 2 direction. That's why C value is minus 1. Remaining A and D does not belong to loop 2. That's why A and D values are 0 and 0. Next, third. Third loop. Third loop branches are A, C, E, D. A, C, E, D. Now, A, see everyone, A and D and E. A, D, E are clockwise direction as like loop direction. That's why I am taking those three values are plus 1. A, D, E. Now, remaining C is in anticlockwise direction. So, I consider minus 1. B does not belong to loop 3. Because if you consider B, that will not form any loop. That's why I am removing the B so that loop 3 is formed. That's why B value is 0. Here, this is a generalized draw. By using this basic knowledge, we are going to draw the fundamental tie set matrix. Fundamental tie set matrix. Given a graph, select a tree, then each link gives rise to a loop. We already explained. First, we should select one tree, then add each link to the tree, then you will get loop. Already I told, when loop is added to tree, that circuit will become closed. Now, loops formed in this way are the minimum number of loops of a graph. They are the fundamental loops. F loops are tie sets. Now, the number of tie sets is equal to the number of links. If links are three, now how many tie sets will form? Three tie sets. Now, the orientation of the loop is defined by the orientation of the corresponding link. Now, orientation is nothing but direction. Direction of the loop completely depends upon the link direction, right? Now, this is example, one of the example in order to write the tie set matrix. This is a generalized example how to mention the values of given loop. Now, we are going to see the fundamental tie set matrix solution. Now, see everyone. Node 1, node 2, node 3, 4. Four nodes are there. Branches are A, B, C, D, E. Five branches are there. Now, in this, see everyone clearly. First, I am going to draw the tree. Tree is nothing but a dark line without any closed loop. First, B, D, E. This is a tree. If you add one link to the tree, that is A link, this will be loop 1. One more link C, that will be loop 2. Now, first, how many tie set forms? Two tie set will form. Why? Because we have two links. Now, first link is tie set A. Second link is tie set C. Link A and C are the links, two links. Now, first one. First loop, how many branches are there including link? Link is A, branches are B and D. Now, tie set C, that is link C. How many branches are there including link C? B and E branches are there. Now, so always we consider branches in horizontal way, A, B, C, D, E. A, B, C, D, E. Now, A and C are the links. A and C are the link branches. First A, that is link. In this loop, we follow this link direction, that is A link, link A direction. Now, what is the link A direction? Clockwise direction. Now, what if you put D direction? D also clockwise, that's why D value is positive. A by default take positive. Why? Because we are taking with respect to link only, that's why A consider A is link. Now, what about B? B is anti-clockwise. See everyone. Starting like a arrow, like this, anti-clockwise. So, in this loop, A is clockwise, D is clockwise. We always follow the link. Here, link is A. That's why A and D are 1, 1. B is anti-clockwise direction with respect to A. That's why minus 1. Same like loop 2. Loop 2, we should follow the link C direction. What is this link C direction? C branch. Link is C here. Now, C direction is what? Which direction? Anti-clockwise direction. The anti-clockwise direction, in this, B and E are branches. B, E are following the clockwise direction with respect to loop 2. That's why B and E, I am considering minus 1. Why? Because link C branches clockwise. Next, B suffix F, fundamental tie set matrix. See everyone, BDE AC. BDE, BDE means fix BDE. In this graph, BDE are dark lines, straight lines. Those are nothing but tree branches. We call them as fix. Next, 1001. This is what links. A and C are links. Now see, 1001. That is what unitary matrix. So we can write the combination of tie set matrix is combination of tick matrix as well as link matrix. Link matrix is nothing but unitary matrix. That's why unitary matrix. The orders are order of tick matrix is NL cross NT. Order of link matrix or unitary matrix is NL cross NL. Clear everyone? So while writing matrices for the cut set, or sorry, tie set, we always concentrate on links. If links are, if the links are two, there will be two loops. If links are three, there will be three loops. One more point is each loop contains one and only link. Each loop contains one and only link. One loop should not contain more than one link. One loop should not contain more than one loop. If one, for example, if it is one loop, in one loop, one link, remaining all are twigs only. Twigs means nothing but dark lines, straight lines, branches of tree. Now, these are the properties of next, already this one over. Tie set over. Next, we are going to see the cut set matrix, start matrix represented with Q. A cut set is a cut set through a graph in any direction which can be divided into only two parts. By removing a set of branches from a linear graph without affecting the nodes, two connected subgraphs are obtained and the original graph becomes unconnected. The removal of these set of branches, which results in cutting a graph into two parts, are known as cuts. Don't worry, dear students. So while solving the problem, we come to know, we can able to write all the properties, right? So I will explain each and every property whenever we are going to solve the problem, right? A cut set separates the nodes of graph into two groups, each being in one of the two groups. The rank of the original graph reduces by one. Everyone. So this is the notation. Each branch of the cut set, obviously, has one of its terminals incident at node in one group and its other end incident at node in the other group. The orientation of the cut set is arbitrary and assumed to have a orientation from one of the two groups of the linear graph to the other. See, one point I would like to discuss. While reading the properties, you may feel some complicated. What is this terminology? Branches, leaving, ending, cutting, two graphs, subgraphs, and everything. Whenever, after solving of the problem, you can easily understand the properties of that corresponding matrix. That may be incident matrix, cut set matrix, or tie set matrix. Okay? Now see. QIB, that is a value, plus one. If branch B is in cut set C and the orientations are same. See everyone, value is plus one. If branch B is in cut set C are same direction. If it is minus one, if branch B and cut set C are in different direction. Zero, if branch B is not in cut set C. We will see what is this. Now, consider one general example. So this is a graph. See everyone, how many nodes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So according to my convenience, I consider six cut sets. See everyone, at node 1, first cut set, node 2, second cut set, node 3, third cut set, node 4, fourth cut set, node 5, crossing from A, B, E, and node 6, crossing the line, dotted lines B, C, D. So I am representing cut set with dotted in the form of arc. In the form of arc. Here, see everyone. First cut set direction leaving from the node. Second cut set direction also leaving from the node. Third direction right side. Third cut set leaving from the node. Fourth cut set leaving from the node. And fifth cut set right side like this. And sixth cut set downward. Now here I am drawing complete cut set matrix QC. This is an example. So later we will discuss. Later we are going to draw the. We are going to calculate the matrix for the cut set. Same like C. Always take branches A, B, C, D, E in horizontal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are our cut set. See everyone. First one. Cut set 1. Cut set 1. See everyone. Direction is what? In cut set 1, branches are A and D. Now, cut set 1, I consider the direction leaving from the node. Leaving from the node. So, the branches who are leaving from the node will be taken as positive. The branches who are entering into the node, that will be minus. See everyone. How many branches are there? A and D. A and D, A is entering, that's why minus 1. D is leaving, that's why plus 1. Why? Because I consider the direction of cut set arrow leaving from the node. Next, node 2. Node 2 also leaving from the node. So in node 2, how many branches are there? Node 2, that is cut set 2. Cut set 2, how many branches are there? B, D, E. In this B, D, E, how many branches are leaving from the node? Only one branch, that is E. That's why E is positive 1. Remaining branches B and D are entering into the node. That's why minus 1, B and D. Remaining branch A, branches A and C are not connected to this cut set. That's why values are 0, 0. Same, see everyone, see 3. Cut set 3. Cut set 3 direction is leaving from the node. Leaving from the third node. So cut set 3 branches are C and E. C is entering, so definitely minus value. Why? Because our cut set direction is leaving from the node. Now this arrow is cut set direction. Now what about E? E also entering, that's why E value will be minus. Remaining values are 0. Why? Because those branches are not connected to cut set. Next, same like cut set 4. Cut set 4 also direction leaving from the node. Now B leaving, A leaving, that's why A and B are positive. C also leaving, that's why A, B, C are positive. Similarly, you can write, you can apply cut set 5 and cut set. This is a generalized example. By using this concept, we are going to calculate cut set matrix for the given graph. So similarly, first, we consider general graph, which is considered general. We took this some my own directions and I completed the matrix. By using this concept, I calculated tie set matrix for the given graph. Same here also, I consider the general graph and taken some cut sets. And taken some direction, my own direction, and completed the complete cut set matrix. By using this concept, by using this knowledge, I am going to calculate the matrix for the given graph, cut set matrix for the given graph. See, we have seen that a tree of graph has ticks. Removing a tick from the tree separates the tree into two parts and correspondingly nodes into tree into two groups. All the links which join node in one set to a node in the other suffer with a tick constitute a cut set called fundamental cut set. You don't worry about all these points. You come to know each and every point, you can clearly understand while solving the problem. Now, since a tree of a graph has ticks, we have cut set defined with are linearly independent. The orientation of cut set assumed to be have the orientation of the corresponding twig. Already you know twig is a dark line, straight line, a branch of tree. So whereas in tie set matrix we should consider the link direction we should consider the link direction present in the loop, right? So I'm comparing present matrix with you. Please try to understand. Now, this is the graph. We are going to draw the fundamental cut set. See everyone. Each cut set, the property, see everyone. Each cut set should consist one and only trig branch. That is one and only tree branch. That is one and only dark line. Remaining all are links only. See everyone. First cut set one. So how many? First identify the twigs. How many twigs are there? A, B, C. That is tree branches are called twigs. A, B, C. Now you can see at node one we can form one cut set. That is twig A and branch D. Branch D is a link. Twig A is what? Branch D is a link. A is what? Twig. So A comma D. Cut set one. At node two we can form one more cut set. That is B. B is twig. D is what? D is what? Link. E is what? Link. In this, more than one link. Two links are there. No problem. So, but twig should be one only. In each and every cut set, twig should be unique. That one only, one twig present. Remaining all are links only. Next, at node three, we can form one more cut set. Why? Because at node three, one twig is C. One more one is E is link. One link, one twig. Now at node four, we cannot form any cut set. Why? Because at node four, A is twig, B is twig, C also twig. What is our condition while forming the cut set? One twig should present. One twig should present. How many twigs are there at node four? A, B, C. So we cannot make any cut set here. Now we will calculate matrix for this cut set, fundamental cut set. A, B, C, D, E are the branches. 1, 2, 3 are the cut sets, not nodes here. Cut sets. Now, cut set 1. How many branches are there? A and D. See everyone, cut set 1, we should follow the twig direction. Whereas in tight set matrix, we should follow the link direction. Whereas in cut set matrix, we should follow the twig direction. In tight set matrix, we should follow the link direction. In cut set matrix, we should follow the trig direction. Clearly, I'm explaining, I'm comparing previous matrix also. Listen carefully. Now, cut set one. What is the trig here? A. A, definitely, default, you consider one. By default, you consider A value is one. Why? Because A is trig. We should follow the trig direction. A is what? Towards the node. A is what? Towards the node. What about D? D away from the node. That's why D will be minus. BCE does not belongs to cut set. That's why BCE value is 0. Now C, node 2. Sorry, cut set 2. In cut set 2, one twig present. That twig is B. So B value definitely by default plus 1. Now what is D's direction? B's direction towards the node. Towards the node. In cut set 2, remaining branches are D and E. D is towards the node. So trig also towards the trig towards the node. So D also towards D will be less. E will be away from the node, leaving from the node. But in this cut set, our trig direction is what? Towards the node. So E will be minus, remaining all zeros. In cut set three, what is the trig? C, branch C is the trig. The direction is towards the node, and one more branch E will exist. E's direction is also towards the node, so E will be positive. By default, C consider positive. Why? Because C is the trig of this cut set 3. Now, properties of cut set. A cut set divided the set of nodes into two subsets. Each fundamental cut set contains one tree branch and the remaining elements being links. Already I told, each fundamental cut set should contain one and only trig branch. Remaining all are links only. Next, each branch of the cut set has one of its terminal incident at a node in one subset and its other terminal at a node in other subset. A cut set is oriented by selecting the orientation from one of the two parts of the two parts to the other. Generally, the direction of the cut set is chosen same as the direction of the tree branch. Just now I explained while solving the problem, we always consider the tick direction. In cut set, we always follow the tick direction. What about in tie set? In loop, we always follow the link direction. We'll always follow the link. Dear students, listen. In incident matrix, we have three matrices: incident matrix, tie set matrix, cut set matrix. In incident matrix, tie set matrix, cut set matrix, horizontal, we will take horizontal branches in horizontal manner. Now, first, in incident matrix, we will consider nodes in vertical manner. The directions are: if any branch entering into the node, that will be treated as -1. If any branch leaving from the node, that will be treated as +1 in incident matrix. Okay, if any branch leaving from the node, that will be +1. If any branch entering into the node, that will be -1. Next, second matrix, that is tie set matrix. Tie set matrix, first we need to identify number of links present in the graph. If number of links are 2, there exists 2 loops. If number of links are 3, there exist 3 loops. Now, the direction of the loop completely depends upon the link direction. If link is clockwise, the branches present in the loop, if any branches present in the loop are clockwise, that branches will be considered as +1. So you can revise the problem solving. Now, whereas in third matrix, that is cut set matrix, in tie set matrix, second matrix, each loop should consist one link only. More than one link not possible in any loop in tie set matrix. If one loop, one link, remaining all are peaks only, tree branches only. Next, third matrix, cut set matrix. We always follows the cut set direction. Cut set direction is nothing but twig direction. Twig is nothing but tree branch direction. Tree branch direction is nothing but straight line, dark line. Now, one important point in the cut set matrix is each cut set should consist one twig only. Remaining all are links only. Those links will take the direction with respect to the twig direction. That is the fundamental concept in cut set matrix. Now, for tomorrow's class, next class, we will solve minimum 2 problems for each and every matrix. So that you can understand very well, dear students, while solving the problem itself, you can able to write the properties of the corresponding matrix. Simply by adding the properties, that is not a good manner. While solving the problem itself, you can able to write the properties of that particular matrix. Thank you.